Hi guys, good morning. Today I'm going to demonstrate to you the theft detection function of the Hioki CM3286-01. This is a continuation of the video that I presented before, the one about the energy comparison function. In essence, the theft detection function that was advertised by Hioki in their website as applied to this clamp meter is a clever application of the energy comparison function. The setting on the energy is right here, and as you can see, there is nothing in the clamp meter that says this is a theft detection function or this is energy comparison function. Rather, inside the setting of watt hour, we can see that there are several ways to measure the energy, and one of them is, of course, if we just merely turn off the meter constant and then start measurement of the energy of whatever it is that we are measuring, and the instrument will continue monitoring the energy of that load for as long as the battery here can supply the power for this clamp meter. But the energy comparison function of this clamp meter works using the second method of measuring energy in this setting, and that is using the meter constant, which we can select here inside. For example, 300 cycles per kilowatt hour, 500, 600. But what we're interested here is, of course, the 500 cycles per kilowatt hour, because this is the one that matches the meter constant of the energy meter that we are going to use for this experiment. The values here are adjustable, actually. And I can change the value of the meter constant here from 500 cycles per 2 kilowatt hour, but that would not be the same as the value here in the energy meter, so we'll just return that one to its default value of 500 cycles per kilowatt hour. Now, the way the energy comparison function works is by synchronizing the start and stop of this instrument with the energy pulses of that energy meter. And the energy pulses of this meter will blink every 2 watt hour of energy that is passing through this meter. So when we start the measurement, we have an expected value of 2 watt hour. And then when we stop the measurement at the next blink of that pulse light, we can compare the measured value with the expected value. So ideally, the two values should be the same, or at least very close to each other. We have here a load, and it is being metered, and it is connected, of course, to the 230 volt 60 hertz service voltage supply. So all the energy being consumed by the metered load here passes through the energy meter, which means that the metered kilowatt hour is exactly the same as the actual kilowatt hour. So this is an ideal scenario. And I can simulate that one by simply connecting using my illustration board, by connecting a load here right after the energy meter. The energy measured by the clamp meter is exact, should also be the same, or at least very close to the energy being measured by the energy meter in this location. Now I have connected my oven load, 400 watts, to the demonstration board, and this load will be metered by this energy meter, which has a meter constant of 500 impressions per kilowatt hour. Again, that means that every blink of the pulse energy light here will register a 2 watt hour energy in this meter. That was a start. So we're now waiting for the next pulse of light to stop the measurement so that we can compare the values. So that was a second pulse of light. Let's compare the values. So now I have a measured value of 2.02 watt hour against an expected value of 2 watt hour. This is a good result, which means that the meter, the energy meter that we are using, is properly working. So now we're going to simulate a situation where a load is being connected that does not pass through the meter. So this is my second scenario. We have a load here, and it is being metered by the energy meter in this location, and it is supplied to a 230-volt 60-hertz voltage. But unlike scenario number one, right before the meter there is a line that goes to another load point, which we will I will refer to as unmetered load. So this is the unmetered kilowatt hour. In other words, the metered kilowatt hour here is not equal to the total kilowatt hour, because there is an energy that is being used that is not passing through this meter. I'm going to simulate that scenario by connecting my demonstration board in this manner. I still have my oven right after the energy meter here. This is my oven, and my clamp meter in this location will measure the total load. And right before the meter there is a line that goes to the unmetered load. This is the one that I'm going to simulate in the demonstration board. Now here in my demonstration board, that load that is not passing through this energy meter is outlet number 3 here. So if I turn that on, it will supply power to outlet number 3. And just to show you that the energy meter here is independent of this outlet, I'm going to turn off the energy meter. And these outlets here will turn off also. However, my location here for the clamp meter for the CM3286-01 will measure all the energy here in these outlets. I will still use the energy comparison function to determine the differences, if any, between the measured and the expected value. A simulated unmetered load here at outlet number 3. This is my 25-watt dehumidifier and my 30-watt desk fan, for a total of around 58 to 60 watts. And of course my oven load there is 400 watts. I'm going to turn it now. So there is a 400 watt value there. I don't know if you can see it. So now we have a 400 watt here and a 57 watt here, and I'm going now to wait for the blink of the energy pulse to start the measurement. That was a start. So I'm going to wait for the next pulse of light to stop the measurement. That was a stop. So let's see the values. Now I have an expected value of 2 watt hour against a measured value of 2.28 watt hour. So there is a difference of 0.28 watt hour between measured and expected, and the ratio between measured and expected values is 114%. So there is an obvious difference in measured and expected value, and that would be a sign that something might be wrong in the measure, either in the measurement, in the setup. But in this case, since we already know that there is an unmetered load here at outlet number 3, then this is an indication or a confirmation that the simulated electricity theft was detected by this Hioki clamp meter. Let's do a second test. For the second test, I'm going to remove my dehumidifier so that only the 30 watt desk fan will be the unmetered load here. A load being metered would still be my 400 watt oven. That was a start. Stop. The value here is not the same. There's a significant difference of 0.19 watt hour between the measured and the expected watt hour. I'm going to turn off outlet number 3 and measure again the metered load here. So that was a start. Stop. So here the values are exactly the same. So the measured value of 2 watt hour against an expected value of also 2 watt hour. The difference is 0, of course, and the ratio between the measured and expected is 100%. So that shows us that the simulation of the so-called energy theft was really properly detected by this clamp meter, Hioki CM3286-01, using the example load that I've used here, the 400 watt oven, and my dehumidifier and desk fan. So that's it, guys. I hope that this short demonstration was able to show you energy comparison function and a detection of energy or electricity theft. Thank you for watching and stay safe.